Without, and it's surprising that he as a lawyer had spoken so recklessly on so many matters about which he showed such a lack of, he wasn't passionate, lack of dispassion on some of those matters.
Recklessly?
Reckless indeed, because he said things that are taught absolutely untrue. This man has just finished talking to Nigerians saying that this country is being run from UK. Memos are going to the United Kingdom and the ministers are reporting to the president. That's false. He doesn't know it. Look, let me tell you this story. I am aware that a senior official of government had gone to President Buhari in the UK and taken some documents to him and said, deal with. The president said, no, I won't. The man responsible for the country is in Abuja. Go back to him. So I think that if the idea is to make Buhari look good, no, it's even disrespectful of the acting president. The country has gone.
The very fact that you actually mentioned that such a scenario did arise, because one of the things Mr. Adeboro did point to was loyalty. He said quite a number of people will continue to look to the president in the United Kingdom. Yes, the president has done the right thing by referring them to the acting president, but that's how a lot of people view him. He is not the president. He is the acting president. And so their loyalties will continue to lie with the person who appointed them as president.
No, that it doesn't follow. Anybody who says that then doesn't understand the implications of the constitution of this country. Once the president has transferred power wholesale, if you are the inspector general of police and the acting president says, go and do ABC, you are fired if you don't do it. So nobody will joke with their jokes. Yes, we love the president, we are loyal to him, but everyone knows that this is the locus of power, this is the locus of authority.
Shouldn't the people who did that sort of thing be fired?
No.
Why?
Maybe they are mistaken.
What is the mistake? That the president has traveled and he's handed over to his vice.
Yeah, but that...
And he's the acting president and the president is away and they go to the president in the UK to seek his consent to attend to matters which the acting president should be seeing to and shouldn't be fired?
That is to underscore to you that this is a law and order president. If this is a president who wanted power for its own sake, he could probably have been given directives from over there. But he said, no, I've done the right thing. I've handed over to the acting president. Deal with it. And that's how the right thing should be done. Mm.